Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Muhammad Imran Qureshi here with you again for third episode of our systematic literature review workshop. So today we are going to learn about bibliometric analysis. So what are the basics of bibliometric analysis, why we do and how we can perform this bibliometric analysis. So this is the workshop number 3 of series of systematic literature review and meta-analysis. So those who have not seen my first two videos, I am going to provide you the link in this slide and also in the description, so you can check out those videos also. So let us start today's. I hope everybody can listen and there is no issue with the voice and video. If you have any issues or any questions during the presentation, please try to ask few questions in the comment box, or you can write your question at the end of this presentation. I'll try to take all those questions and we'll try to make it as much as possible fruitful for everybody. So let us start today's workshop. So basically today we are going to learn about bibliometric analysis. So I'm Dr. Muhammad Imran Qureshi. Basically I'm working in University Technical Malaysia, Melaka, as a senior lecturer. I'm also director of Connecting Asia, founding director, and also I'm the president of Pakistan chapter of Association of Professional Researchers and Academicians. You can check out this website for more detail. And I'm also editor of few journals in Reader Insight Publisher, so Journal of Management Info and Social Transformation and Educational. Okay, so this is my brief introduction. Those who want to see me, you can stay connected with me. You can do some emails on systematicliterature@gmail.com, and also our Facebook page is there, and I also give you my YouTube channel's link, so you can find me any of these platforms. Okay, so this is our, as I mentioned, this is our third workshop of the series of systematic literature review and meta-analysis. So these two workshops which we already conducted, they are connected with today's workshop. So those who have not saw those videos, so I'm just giving you the link so you can see those videos and prepare the initial work which we are going to use today in our workshop. So I hope everybody have already checked this out, and if you have not done, please do it and feel free to ask any question if you have. I'm a bit quick today because today's workshop is a bit more on practical side, so that's why I will give you some brief introduction of a few things, and then I'll quickly move to my important part of this today's session, the practice session. Okay, but before that, we have a very important announcement for today. Announcement is this: we have just started one journal which is based on this community which we have recently developed, Systematic Literature Review and Meta-Analysis journal, which we are basically focusing on volunteer work from all the editors, all the authors and reviewers. So we have this call for paper, for papers, also for editorial board and for reviewers. So all of you, we request you to apply for these editorial board members, reviewers, and also send us papers. So this is, we are trying to develop this journal based on the community we have recently developed, and of course you are part of this community, so we have to contribute. So this is a free journal, no fee for publication or no fee for any review or anything. So basically this is a volunteer based journal, so everybody can contribute as per their experience and their level of contribution. So this is the website, you can check slr-m.com. this is the journal website, so you can browse through the website. We have recently completed our first issue. I hope so we can be, publish this issue within 2 or 3 days, but we need contribution from everyone, all these community, systematic literature review and meta-analysis community which we have developed recently. Okay, and at the same time I have already showed you our video of our exhibition which was at the starting of this workshop. So if you want to submit any of your projects or infographics or research in that contribution or in that project exhibition as an innovative idea, you can do that, and you can have a price of RM 15,000, which is for the all contribution for the winner. So you can try for that also. We will share the link for that exhibition also. Okay, let us start. So this is for just for few announcement. Let's start for our bibliometric analysis. First, we should see what are the learning outcomes for today. The learning outcomes I divided into five different objectives. The first learning outcome is trying to understand the bibliometric basic concept. Then we will see what are the methods and software that are available, how we can prepare ourselves for data analysis, and how we can do that data analysis in practice, and then and finally how we can interpret the result we receive from this data analysis using a bibliometric analysis software. I will try to cover few parts, but I will give you overview of all bibliometric analysis. Maybe we can have another series of bibliometric analysis, because it is not possible to cover everything in one presentation or in one workshop for 1 hour. So what I'll do, I'll try to divide this into some of small workshops or small videos, so everybody can get benefit of it, and we hope that we can prepare good papers from this meta-analysis and systematic literature review, including bibliometrics techniques. Okay, so these are learning outcomes for today's workshop. So first we'll study about some of the basic concepts, why we do this and what is bibliometric analysis, and then we do and we see what softwares are available, and then we see how we can develop understanding based on that software and outputs of that software. So this is our today's learning outcome. Let's see what is bibliometric analysis. Basically, it's very simple. It's utilization of statistical and mathematical techniques to see whether the books or the journals, the articles, citations, all these, any other publication material. So we try to analyze all these situations, books, journals, articles, reviews, whatever is already published, by using statistical approaches. So it starts with the quantitative side, sorry, qualitative side, but later on it moves through the statistical approaches. So I'll tell you how we can use these statistical approaches. If you remember in the previous lecture, we started with the data extraction. We use keywords, all those text queries, and I gave you some examples of how we can extract data from different databases. So that was basically first part of our systematic literature review process. That's why I told you that is very fundamental or basic concepts which we studied, how we can develop our data sheet, how we can extract data, very simple concept. And I also explained to you how you can write a very simple data analysis or a systematic literature review paper. Okay, now we are just entering into the extended part of that thing. Okay, systematic literature review. We can use bibliometric analysis along with systematic literature review to strengthen our paper and to publish it in good journals. Okay, so that technique is, you can couple it with the systematic literature review. We already covered that part. So how we can do it and what are the basics, we'll study later on, okay, in this slide. Okay, so what are the methods available for bibliometric analysis? I told you it is basically analysis of our published material with the statistical and mathematical procedures. So very simple definition, but the application is a bit tricky. So we can see what type of analysis are possible. Remember, the first possibility is citation analysis. We try to test, or we try to check, or we try to analyze, or we try to assess the citations of all published material. Maybe it can be papers, it can be book, or any other relevant material which is citable. Okay, so we do citation analysis. But remember, citations, we have two types of the citation analysis. We call it forward and backward. If one paper, it have 30 citations, 30 different references are already available in that paper. and we are trying to assess each and every paper which a particular paper have cited. This is called backward citation. Okay, we are going back from that paper. Okay, this is called backward citation. In the forward citation, we try to assess how many other articles they have cited this particular paper. Okay, now two things: the article have been cited and article cited different article in its reference list. So this is forward and backward citations. This is very simple logic. So this is two types of the citation, but this is not all we do in bibliometric analysis. This is just a basic understanding. So what we do, we try to see co-citations. Co-citations mean how many articles have particularly cited co-citations, mean one article A and one article B, okay, and one article C. So A, B, C, they have been co-cited. Okay, so mean that they are present in each other reference list. Then another technique, we call it bibliographic coupling. What we do, let's say article A have cited article C and article B have also cited article C. There is a tendency that this article A and B are same or similar area of research, similar field, or maybe similar outcome, because they are citing same article. So if in the reference list the more articles are bibliographic coupled, it means that the articles are similar in nature. Okay, so this is how we do, but we can use software to do that. Okay, so this is called bibliographic coupling. So this is the second type of this citation analysis. Let's say co-authorship. Similar to co-citations, how many authors are available in each other paper, means that we can figure out how many different authors they have worked together in some particular paper. So this is co-authorship analysis. That is also we can do. Let's say Mr. A have worked with Mr. B in one paper and Mr. B have worked with Mr. C. So this is, we can try to analyze how different authorships they work together in particular articles. Okay, so this is co-authorship analysis. And then very important, but this is not based on the citations or references, it is based on the keywords we use in particular article. So the keyword, how many keywords have been co-occurred. So mean article A have used, let's say, technology, article B also used technology, and article C also used technology, means that these keywords are co-occurred in three articles. So this is keywords co-occurrence, very important technique of bibliometric analysis. Okay, so co-occurrence. So this is about citation analysis, but there is another method we do, or we use it in our bibliometric analysis, but mainly it is a qualitative data analysis technique. We call it text mining, or also you can say it is a content analysis. Okay, so content analysis is also another type of bibliometric analysis. In content analysis, here in bibliometric analysis, what we can use, term co-occurrence. Let's say in the abstract, we can export the abstract. If you remember from the Scopus, we were able to extract the abstract, and you already have that data in your file. It means that you are able to find out how different terms have been co-cited in different articles. Okay, so this is co-occurrence of terms. Okay, so this is basically based on the main your abstract, not keywords, abstract. But sometime we can use in, like in NVivo, complete article, and we can see how many different terms have been used in the different articles. So there are softwares available that can help you in assisting with the data analysis in this type of particular query. Okay, so we can use content analysis based on terms co-occurrence. So that is also possible in bibliometric analysis. Okay, so these are main techniques or methods we use for citation analysis. From here, Remember co-citations and keyword co-occurrence. These two techniques, you can extend them to exploratory factor analysis, we call it EFA, or you can do with the principal component analysis and k-means also. So you can use some in detail statistical procedures on these co-citations and keywords co-occurrence. Okay, so that is very much possible, but I'll tell you in next maybe workshops how we can do this principal component analysis and k-mean analysis from this bibliometric data, because we have to develop a correlation matrix. So that we will do in next workshop, hopefully soon. I'll try to find some time and I'll show you this. Okay, so now today we will focus on all these and we will see what softwares are available to use this content analysis and citation analysis. Okay, clear? So let's see what are the softwares which we can use for this. Most importantly, I must say the most powerful software in dealing all type of data situation is Microsoft Excel. You can use that Excel, but obviously the software have some limitations. So we have Bib Excel, we have Hit Sites, we have Site Space, we have Was Viewer, we have Giphy, we have InGraph, which we use in R. This is a package. And also we have NVivo. You can use NVivo 12, 13 or whatsoever software latest is available to you. Okay, so these all are the software. I cannot cover everything, but I will try to help you in getting this Bib Excel, Was Viewer, Site Space, Giphy and NVivo, but in different workshop, not here. Today we will focus on Was Viewer only because of many reasons. I'll explain it to you why I choose Was Viewer, because it have some added advantage on Site Space and Bib Excel again. Okay, so Bib Excel, Excel, these are mostly text based software, but Site Space, Was Viewer, Giphy, NVivo and InGraph, these paper iGraph, these software can give you graphical outputs and it can give you a lot of other options. So I have already shared this links to you. You can download Was Viewer if you want to follow my steps. You can download, the link is already available in the comment box, and I also paste it now, so you can use this link to download the Was Viewer. Okay, meanwhile I'm going with the other content of the workshop. Okay, so you can use Was Viewer, you can use Giphy. I can share all the links to all these software. All software have some advantages and some disadvantages, which we will learn later on. But I hope you can for this workshop, you can download Was Viewer and we can do some analysis, because most of us, we already have a data sheet with us. If you don't have, don't worry, I'll tell you how to extract data sheet from different sources today also in a very short time. Okay, so these are the software. I hope everybody understood this concept. So just I'm sharing you this link to Was Viewer and you can download, it's a free software. Okay, now the first thing we understood, that what we need mean the method. Second thing we learned, how we do, which is software. And the third is output. What is you are going to get from this outcome from this software? Okay, so let's see what type of outcomes we want from these bibliometric analysis. Okay, so first we can see article, author, journal status based on the citation, based on number of years of publication, number of article publication, author progress, journal progress and article status. All these can be done from this outcome from this software. Okay, so if you want to know whether author A is performing well, author A is contributing with the different countries, author A is collaborating with the different universities, author A is publishing in different journal, all these can be find out from this data analysis from this software. The second one, we can discover new knowledge. we can discover what practices have been done and where the future lies in. So we can see previous studies, and we can find out majority of the researchers what they are thinking and what would be the future of that particular situation. For example, digital technologies. So we are looking at, okay, whether digital technologies can be used in medical. So if I want to see, I would do with this analysis and see how many different studies have been done on this particular field and what is the future. So I can discover knowledge. Okay, theoretical diffusion, that is very important concept, especially for those who are related to social sciences. If they want to know what is the status of a theory in the past, in the present, and what would be the future of that theory. For example, innovation diffusion theory. For example, resource-based view theory. We want to see how many different researchers and what are the number of articles in the past and what are the type of the fields where these studies or theories have been implemented. Okay, so we can see the theoretical diffusion also. Okay, so that is one of this analysis mediums. Okay, we can see intellectual structures of any concept. For example, I want to see digital HR, human resource, digital human resource. What are the definitions? How many elements have been included? How different authors they define this concept? So that can be done by this bibliometric analysis, and we can understand this systematic literature review and bibliometrics. Okay, and then we can see obviously development of knowledge over the time, and also we can see the research collaboration, very important part. Research collaborations, maybe we want to see whether USA is collaborating with Malaysia or not in let's say sustainable future, sustainable buildings, a particular disease, let's say COVID. How many researchers they are collaborating and working together? So that can be find out from this bibliometric analysis. Okay, and then we can always find out what are the emerging fields in particular situation, and we can see how different fields are working together. Okay, so this is a brief theoretical background of what we are going to do today. Okay, but the most important part, we have to understand the research question. What is our research question, which is we already covered in the past lectures. So you can see my video previous to understand why and how we can develop research question before starting any systematic literature review or bibliometric analysis. This research question will lead you to the method, and the method will lead you to outcome. So means that these three things are always interconnected. So what you want to do, you have to decide at first, okay? And then you can use software and other techniques to help you or to assist you in order to make your decisions, okay? So research question, methods and outcomes, they are always linked together in all types of research. Here also, you have to develop your research question first. You have to extract data based on that research question. Then you need to choose method of your bibliometric analysis, and then you need to get your outcome. So I told you different outcome, so you have to think what outcome you need for your analysis. I'll tell you different types of the outcomes and analysis, but most importantly, you are the one who have to decide what analysis need to be done in your paper or in your thesis. Okay, so let's move. I think we are clear on this point. So we should know that research question, methods and outcomes, they are interlinked. Okay, now let's get to the practical side. Now we need to understand, we have to rethink how we can extract data. I told you in the previous lectures, Web of Science, Scopus, you can import data, and in the second lecture I also explained how you can export data from Mendeley, and you can use Google Scholar and all. Today I bring one more tool for you. If you don't have Scopus, don't worry about it. If you don't have any access to Web of Science, no problem at all. You can use Publish or Perish tool, and it is a free tool available on this website, and you can download this tool and you can use it to extract as much as data you want. I am just going to show you how you can extract this data from the publish or perish. This is basically a website. I have already given you a link for this website, so you can use this website in order to extract this software. Okay, so what I did, I just clicked on this website. Okay, here you can see we are here. If you write on the Google Scholar, or sorry, Google Chrome, you can just write publish or perish. You will get this first website, hazing.com. So you can use that website and download this software for you. Okay, so this software is available for Linux, Microsoft Windows, and also Mac operating system. So it is free software. You can just use this software to extract any form of bibliographic data from different sources without paying anything. Obviously, we cannot extract from Scopus directly without having username and password, but still we can extract from Google Scholar, and we can extract from other mediums also. When you install this software, this is the first look of this software. Okay, so I'm just giving you one example. Okay, now this is the first outlook of this software. This software will help you to extract your bibliographic data from Crossref, from Google Scholar, Google Scholar profile also. You need to use you can extract from Microsoft Academics, but remember, for Microsoft Academic you have to create a free account in the Microsoft Academic. You can use that, and also you can use Web of Science and Scopus. But remember, Web of Science and Scopus, you have to pay the fee, and then if you have any institutional account, you can do it for. Okay, so here we understood this is free data source, and this is data source where registration is required, and this is external subscription required, mean that it is a paid version of your data analysis. Okay, data extraction. So what we can do now, let's say I want to search something. Okay, I want to search for new cross reference. I want to search from Google Scholar. Let's try one Google Scholar here. Okay, from Google Scholar, I'm just using this is the platform. When I click on the Google Scholar, you have these options. So you can choose any author, you can restrict number of years here, you can use publication name, or you can use ISSN number, you can use title words, you can use keywords. So what all these options are available, you can use any option, but the same algorithm is same. You have to use your software queries based on inverted commas, which I already explained in the lecture 2 or 1. You can just see that lecture, how to extract data. So just search, click here search. Now it will start searching data for you from any sources. Okay, now this is very important, those, because I receive a lot of queries. Many of my friends are very worried about it because they don't have access to Scopus, they don't have access to Web of Science. So in that case, what they can do for developing this bibliometric analysis or all this, so no worries about it. We have different software. One software I told you in the lecture 2, where we use Mendeley to extract data from free sites. But at the same time, we can use this Google Scholar. You can use this Google Scholar data, and you can just extract all the information. Now, if you see what is here, this is the information for each article. Okay, let's say this is H-index citations. It is 634 citation for first article. Per year citation, it is almost 105. The rank is 1. Authors, the author names are here. You can see all the author detail, and you can see the article also, okay? So if you see here, okay, and then you can see the publication, means that the journal name, you can see the publisher, you can see what type of document is available, PDF, it is book or it is article or whatsoever. So this information is available here, which we are going to use in our bibliometric analysis. What you can do, you can just control and A, select all, just right click here. Once you right click, you will see options. Okay, so you can export all these options in any form. Let's say save results as a BibTeX, as a CSV file, as a EndNote, as a ISO file. I'm just trying to save it as a reference manager file, because we can use this in many other referencing software like Mendeley, EndNote. Also, you can use this for bibliometric analysis in WAS Viewer, so that is also possible for you. Okay, so just save it, give it a name where you want to save it. Let's say I saved it in my downloads. Now this file is already saved in my downloads. This is popsites.ris. So this is the file which we created, just created. So all this bibliometric data is already saved in your file. So you can use this tool. This is very handy tool for those who don't have access to Scopus and other structured databases. So you can use that. Okay, it brings all data to you. So I hope this is a very good tool in terms of your, you know, handy tool in terms of your research. Okay, now let's go back to this. We understood this software. Now you can extract data, bibliometric data, from any of the sources, or sources are not a limitation. Now you can use Scopus, you can use Web of Science. If you don't have access to these Scopus and Web of Science, you can use it in Google Scholar and all other software. So data can be exported in any form. Okay, clear? So let's move on. We are clear about this situation. We have this publish or perish software now. Thanks to the developer, they give us a very handy tool, and we can use it in our research. So let's move forward, because we have a little time today. It's only 1 hour and we have to cover some other topics also. So we are clear how we can extract data from publish or perish. We can extract data from Scopus, we can extract data from Mendeley, we can extract data from Web of Science. These I have already explained to you in lecture 1 and 2. Let's move now. Main content of today, we are going to learn VOS Viewer as a bibliometric software. But what we can do with that, the practical application I will tell you later on. But first, what we want to achieve from this software, bibliometric analysis software. The first, I already explained, we can do co-citation analysis. Okay, we can do bibliometric coupling analysis, we can do co-authorship analysis, we can do keywords co-occurrence. These are simple bibliometric analysis tools. But why I choose this WAS Viewer is because it can extract terms also from the data we exported from Scopus. If you remember, we have the abstract also. So if you have abstract and all other information in any sheet, you can use that to extract the key terms co-occurrence in your abstracts. That is very important. It is extension. It is not just focusing on keywords, but it is also focusing on what terms you are repeatedly used, or people have repeatedly used in their abstract. So we can use this text analysis also. That is the value addition this VOS software is giving us. So that's why I think this software is good enough for basic, because it's very easy, and also it gives us some added advantage over other software. Yes, there are some limitations, because we cannot generate covariation matrix or correlation matrix from Voss Viewer. That is the limitation where we have to use BIP, Excel and other software. Later on in next workshops we will learn how we can do that, because we have to go towards a bibliometric analysis, and then we have to do principal component analysis and factor analysis also. So this is basically a very basic software, but it is very good software to start with. So let's start today. The website for Java, so you can download from there easily. So it is very easy software. Once you download, you can run it easily. Just extract and click on the Voss Viewer, then you will see this type of this screen. So this is your first interaction with this software, where we want to do some bibliometric analysis. We want to see co-citation analysis. We want to see keywords analysis. We want to see other bibliometric analysis, so we can use this data. But remember, we already have data with us. We have data from Scopus. If you learn that in workshop 1 or 2, and if you don't have, you can just use this software, publish or perish, and you can extract data from there. Okay, so data is already available. I assume that you have already extracted the data, because we have already gone through this process before. If you don't, you just see my previous lecture. Okay, let's move on. This is the platform we have to use, and this is the software we are going to use to do the bibliometric analysis. But what is the bibliometric analysis again? Just give you some a reminder. This is the co-citation. You can do co-citation, you can do bibliographic coupling, you can do co-authorship, you can do keywords co-occurrence, or you can do terms co-occurrence. So these are the objectives we want to achieve from this software. The process is very simple, the method is very easy. I'm just going to tell you, but remember, these are the different techniques we can use. But remember, this is depending on your research question, which platform you are using and what outcomes you want to achieve from bibliometric analysis. Okay, so let's create one. So if you go to create, it will give you three options. Okay, the first option is create a map based on network data. If you already have network data, you can use it. Other softwares give you network data, and also you can extract network data from Voss Viewer. But for now, we just focus on these two options, second and third options here. Okay, the second option is create a map based on bibliographic data. Okay, and then create a map based on text data. This is the last one where we can see the co-occurrence of terms. Okay, but if you want to use co-authorship, keywords co-occurrence, citation, bibliographic coupling and co-citation, you have to use this option. Okay, very clear. If you want to use co-authorship, you want to extract keyword co-occurrence, citations, bibliographic coupling, co-citations, then you can just use this option. And if you want to use terms co-occurrence, you can use this option, which is based on create a map based on text data. So let's start with some basic analysis first, and then I'll show you how we can do further analysis. Let's say create a map based on bibliographic data. Bibliographic data we just have extracted from this file. You know, if you are using Web of Science, Scopus and others, you can use this option. If you are extracting data, you have extracted data from RIS or EndNote or Mendeley, you can use this option. Okay, and if you are using any other option, Microsoft Academic, Crossref and other data, you can use this option. Okay, through API. Now you have to use this API key, but for now let's just focus on using this RIS data. Okay, RIS data, when you click here, select this option and go to next, you will see where is RIS file. So you just click here. And as you remember, I give you this file. It was in my documents, right? Yes, it was in my, sorry, downloads. Okay, this one is my file which I extracted from PublishOr Perish. The file was not extracted completely. I'm not sure whether all data is available or not, but to give you a flavor, this is enough. Okay, so we just click here, next. Now it will ask you different options. Some options are available, some are inactive. If you use Scopus data, all option will be active. So we have some limitation on this publish or perish also, but still it is very okay to have this, to have this data. Okay, now we have to do the co-authorship and unit of analysis is our author. So we go to next. Here if you see, maximum number of document of an author, it is 3. Let me just give it to 1 because maybe 33 or 388 authors meet the threshold because we have 388 documents. So let me just give it 1 try. Okay, so we have 388 authors. So these are the list of the authors, okay, and their document and total link strength. This is very important data here. If you remember, I asked you, we can export map or network data from other software. From here also you can do it. All are selected, you can just click and export selected authorship and all this. It will give you option to save your data in different files. Okay, so you can select and save this data. This is your authors, documents, a number of documents and a total link strength. It is very useful data. We will learn how we can use this data, but you can export this data in a CSV file. Okay, so let's finish for now. Okay, from these 388 articles, only 6 authors, they were working together. Otherwise, most of them, they are not linked together. So that's why not all authors were presented here. Okay, so you can see that if I want to see Arts K have how many authors, so he have worked with all of these authors. If I click here and I want to see Wall, how many different authors he have worked. He worked with Adams, he worked with Arts. And if I want to see Mefe, and you can see the data shows the result of his co-occurrence of his article. So he was the co-author of Omens, he was the co-author of Banks, and he was the co-author of Arts also. So this is a very simple co-authorship analysis by using WAS Viewer. Okay, so co-authorship or co-occurrence, so means that these authors, they have been working together. Okay, so this is the first type of the analysis. Let's go back. I hope this is basically from the data we extracted from publish or perish. So I was not able to extract complete data because it was asking for my Google profile login. So you can use that login and extract all the data. So with because of limitation of time, I just stopped this process. So that's why it is only 6 authors. But when you do it with the large data set, you will find a lot more authors, they are working together. Okay, this is one option. Let us go and see how Scopus data, it works. Now I choose read data from bibliographic data file, which is basically Scopus Web of Science. We have that Scopus file. If you remember in the past, we had this file. So let me see whether I have saved this file or not. Okay, let me check where is my file. Okay, this is my CSV file, scopus.csv, which we created in the past workshop. So you just click here. This file is already, sorry, incorrect number of columns. Let me sorry, I choose a wrong option. Okay, so just I click Scopus here, and now I can see my Scopus file is the software is reading my Scopus file. So this Scopus file, the data we used or we extracted in our past lecture. If you don't know how to extract data from Scopus, you can see my first video in which I already explained how you can extract data from Scopus and to prepare it for VUS software and other softwares also. So just allow this software to read my file, because it have around 2000 records, so hopefully it will take some time. And the main keywords which I used to extract this data was same. I use digital technologies in the inverted commas. So make sure everybody should understand this. So all article which using keyword, sorry, digital technologies in their title, okay, only in their title, those articles are available here in this file. Maybe it takes some time to extract this data. Okay, now this data have been extracted, and now you can see it gives us a lot more options than the previous data. So this is the limitation when you are using Scopus or any established database. You have a lot of options. Now you can compare authors, you can compare co-authors, you can compare citation, bibliographic coupling, co-citations, based on authors, organizations, and also based on countries. So this is the power of structured data. So you have a lot more options than only from publish or perish. But still, those who don't have any other option, they can use this data for this. Okay, now Scopus, it gives us co-authorship. Let's say I want to see the co-citations. So cited reference or cited source or cited author. So this is the unit of analysis. I'm looking at cited references now. Okay, full counting and fractional counting means that it allows you 1 or 2, and it allows you 1.5 or 2.5. These are all numbers we calculate from the strength. But for now, just keep it to the basics. We use this cited references. Just go to next and make minimum number of citations of article of reference. So I just give it, I think, only 2 references, or let's say 3 references. Okay, so because if I say 3 references cited, so in that case we have enough 277 article which meet this thresholds. Okay, so all these through 77 we need to add. Okay, now this is the same data. If you see the strength of your link, that data we can use for our analysis k-means, and also we can create covariation matrix, which I'll teach you in future workshops. So this is the data available. Now what we need to do is we need to just click on finish, and it will create a network for you. Now you can see this is a very simple, or very beautiful, not just simple, but it is a very beautiful network which shows that the co-occurrence of citations between the articles. Okay, so let's say if I want to see this article where it has been cited with the different authors or different articles. And if I want to see, okay, this one, how many articles they have cited in their paper, they are together, means that whatever reference Bisbandra has cited, it is also available in this other article. So this is a very simple network. And if you see, they are giving you different colors. These colors are basically clusters. So we can, how we can use this cluster values, I will show you later on. But for now, let's focus on the basics. So this is the co-citation analysis based on the references. Okay. Now let us move to the final part based on text. So this, I think you can try, you can just try different options and you can see, you can learn how you can use this bibliometric analysis for your research question. But here I'm interested to tell you, this is based on the text data. This is very important. And you can see how many different terms are studied together. So that's why I want to use this option. So just click on here, just click on next. The same, we are using this bibliographic data from Scopus. So we click here on Scopus, we can just import this file. Now this data would be read from where? Title and abstract of the fields. Or you want to just focus on field, or you just want to focus on abstract. So you can just extract data from title, or you can just abstract these keywords from or terms from abstract, or you can take both. So here I'm taking both, and then we can see what the results are. Okay, so this is now this voice viewer is extracting data. This is basically the content analysis I referred in my presentation. So means that we are using the co-occurrence of terms used in the abstracts and the title field. You can use only abstract or you can use only title fields. It's up to you. But here I use both. So we can see different options. Okay, binary counting or full counting. I am okay with the binary counting. I mentioned we can learn it later on how we can deal with the situation of a binary and full counting. Okay, the minimum number of occurrence of a term. Sometime we can change this if this number is very low. So means that 10 times our terms which is included in this analysis, it is minimum number 10 times it have been in 10 articles it has been occurred. Okay, so means that 10 different documents they have used similar term. Okay, so that's why this is number is 10. We can use it, we can change it to 5, 6, whatsoever based on the required field. But here, if I want to reduce it, I can increase this number. Let's say if I use this 15, you will see here the number is decreased. Okay, so let's say we keep it 15, only 526 terms which meet this criteria, or maybe we can use it for 24. For example, now 397 terms. Again, we go to next, 238 terms are being extracted. So let's see what are these terms, and we can always refine our results here. Digital transformation, I'm very much interested. This is young child, mathematics, enterprise, digital economy, Russia, countries, or all this. So I can choose the terms. If I want to exclude any term from analysis, I can do it. Let's say month, I don't want it, I just excluded this. Okay, the rest maybe we can just leave them. But you can completely assess these terms, and then again, if you see, this is the frequency of occurrence and this is the relevance. These scores are very important, and you can just export these. As I mentioned in the previous slide, you can just right click and then you can just export selected all these numbers in terms of CSV file. So you can save it on your computer for later use. We will do it in our next workshop. So Let's see, these relevant frequencies and occurrences are already here. Let's see how this network is being developed. Okay, now this is the network which is based on co-occurrence of different terms. Okay, and these are the clusters. The colors, it represents the different clusters. Okay, so these different clusters, they represent different options. So you can see how you can name them. For example, if I see these cluster, red cluster is basically business side, maybe this cluster is education side, this cluster, if you can see the professional and personal, this age, year group, so you can name this as a personal factor. So these three clusters are very identical and they are based on the relevant frequency. Okay, so this relevant frequency option, we can change it and we can play with that number. But here I'm interested to tell you all these. Remember, in each cluster, the mean centered term, the term which is available in the center of the cluster, it means that that is the most frequent term available in that analysis, in that cluster. Okay, so here system is the most important term. Here if you see, education is the most important term. Here if you can see, maybe it is scattered because two or three different groups or person. So you can see this is the different option. So you see, this is how different terms have been scattered and how we can use them in a different cluster. So we can name these clusters and we can form our analysis on the basis of these cluster. Okay, we can say that, okay, in this terms frequency, bibliometric analysis tells us we have three different cluster. For example, first cluster represent the business and management because most of the terms are related to economy, management, system, sector, industry. And here if you see, most of the terms, they are related to education. Here most of the terms, they are related to individual characteristics, maybe their age, gender, okay, limitation. But so most of these terms are related to individual characteristics. So that's how we can form these different cluster based on this analysis. Now what we can learn from here? Now there are many things you can learn from this bibliometric analysis, especially the terms co-occurrence. We can see which areas have been studied more and where is the gap. We can see how many different clusters or different groups have been formed with these terms and where the situation is not good. Means that there are some limitation on the literature which have not been studied particularly. Maybe few particular areas you want to focus, they are not available here. So you can see the distribution of the studies and also the distribution of the knowledge within this 2000 article. So what I did, I just used 2000 articles from Scopus database and represented them in a form of a network, and I can represent that network. Okay, now let us see, we can use this country based authorship also. Means that we can say that how many different countries are collaborating together in order to solve any particular issue, that it depending on your research question. Okay, so these techniques are very useful in systematic literature reviews. But here is one tip. Remember, I think that's it for my today's lecture for this bibliometric analysis. You can follow these steps and you can try and learn again and again, and you can make some mistakes also along the way, but at the end of the day you will learn this. If you have any question on this, you can post and I will try to answer it at the end of this presentation. But here is one tip. Systematic literature review, we already studied how to do that and how we can do the classification in the systematic literature review. But try to add bibliometric analysis also in your systematic literature review. Not just the bibliometric analysis is strong enough to be published in very good journals, and not also your systematic literature review, until and unless it depending on a very vital question, research question. But if you are doing something very normal or for the first time, try to couple these two or three options. Try to merge these two or three options in one research article. For example, if you want to see the vaccination of COVID, for example, so you can see how many different countries are working together. So that's why you can do the co-authorship, co-occurrence with respect to the countries. How we can do it? Very simple. Click here. You have this same option. You can go with this option. We also same. Now here you see the co-authorship countries. Okay. Now. Okay. Just a little bit options. Let's say I just extracted that in the digital technologies, these are the countries who are working together in particular research area. Okay. So this is how you can identify the collaborative research through bibliometric analysis. You can use United States. You can see which countries they are working together. Let's say Brazil. Let's say Australia. So we can see how these different countries are forming their research network and how they are working together. That is very simple in this case. So this is how countries can analyze their research output. The universities can do analyze their research output. They can do their collaborative efforts output analysis. All these can be done with this bibliometric analysis. So when you do any systematic literature review paper, so try to add some of these data analysis of bibliometric analysis in your systematic literature review paper. So that will give some strength to your arguments on some particular field. Okay. So I hope you are clear on these parts. You are clear about this utilization of this VOS Viewer software. Workshop, we'll come up with some other tools, or maybe we'll go with some statistical procedure of doing factor analysis from this, or maybe we can go with the meta-analysis also. So this series will be continued, and I hope so in future I will come up with another workshop where we can learn how we can do factor analysis from these bibliometric data. Okay, so I hope everybody is clear and you learn something today. If you want to learn more, you can ask me any question here. And if there is any other question, or later you try, and if you find any queries or any trouble in that, you can post us on our Facebook page. You can contact us on our YouTube channel. I have already provided the links. I'll try to share this presentation link to everybody once it is completed. So let's conclude today's session. I hope everybody understood this you have to, if you have any question, I'm more than welcome to answer. So let me ask few questions.
First question is that Niti Sharma, XML file from Manly to Excel duplicate files are generated. Kindly suggest how to overcome this problem.
Okay, whenever you are exporting from any software like Mendeley, EndNote or any other, try to export in reference manager, RIS file, not XML file. XML is more free or user friendly for EndNote, not for Mendeley or other software. So try to export your file in reference manager or CSV file. That would be very important. If you export in CSV, you can edit whatever you want to edit in that file. Okay.
Hina Chaudhary sir, what should be the minimum or maximum number of papers to do the bibliometric analysis?
Okay. As I mentioned in the bibliometric analysis, the number of papers maybe it do not determine the quality, but remember we have to see whether our analysis is okay or not. Maybe if you let's say in that case I use 388 papers, but only 6 authors were working together, so this number is very little, so I have to increase the number. But in any case, if you get enough number of authors, enough number of co-citation, that would be enough to understand what is going on there. If you extend the data, I think, this is my personal observation, I think the result would be similar what you receive from little data. So no problem with that. You just have to determine by yourself what is the optimum number for this bibliometric analysis. Okay, but based on your network, if your network is complete, it is readable and you can get something from it, you can do it. But sometime we include so many articles and our networks are not readable. So in that case, we have to eliminate unnecessary data. So it depends on your output. Okay, so try and error. Sometime you have to try and you have to learn by yourself. But mostly your network should be interpretable and your network should be representable. Okay, and sorry for one thing I have not included in that. You can export all these values from screenshot. If you want to export these pictures to your paper, you can just export, and you can use blank or maybe a transparent background also. So you can use all these options to export your data. In I hope so in future we will learn it in detail, but if you want to export and include in your paper, you can do it in.
Next question is, what is the main difference between meta-analysis and bibliometric analysis? Does it mean the same thing?
Okay, for the meta-analysis and bibliometric analysis, meta-analysis is depending on the variable. It is very detailed study of your constructs, of your variable, of your main outcomes. While the bibliometric analysis is based on the citation, authorship, countries, all this data. So they are very different things. Because in meta-analysis, we use size of effect size of variable from one variable to another. And we want to see, let's say I want to see one particular medicine is working on patients or not. So in that case, I have to see how many experiments have been done and what was the effect of those medicine on that variable. So I will collect all these data and I will try to see the effect size. So this is meta-analysis, where you use in detail values of your previous researchers, the analysis of previous researcher to display your effect size. Okay, but while bibliometric analysis is just the citation and the author's characteristics of your authorship in the article. So that they are very different things. I hope so we will cover both. But obviously, I have to take you slowly. When you are ready, we will go with the meta-analysis also. Meta-analysis have its own different types, and we can use different structures for meta-analysis. I will cover that part also,
sir,
in future.
Last question. Last, a very important question. What is the eligibility for reviews and editorial work that is already mentioned? And another thing. Call for the papers, please. You can
mention. Okay, we have this call for papers and for reviewers and editors, call for editors. All those who are associate professors and above than associate professor, they can apply for editorial board member. And all who are linked with this society, they can apply for reviewers also. Okay, so we need your data. And at the same time, we have already floated that Google form, and also we need your maybe contribution in terms of articles also. So the plan is, we are going to extend this network, we are going to develop this society in a way that we can benefit from it in terms of our research article to be published, and we will provide that platform too. But obviously that contribution is not just from our side, it is a volunteer contribution, and I urge everybody should participate, because this is a benefit for all of us. So we will see how you can apply, and we will notify you for the reviewer and editorial board. So please apply, and we will go through each and every case, and we'll notify you as soon as possible. At the same time, for the certificates, please mark your attendance. It is already provided. I'll ask my staff again to send you this link. So please mark your attendance so we can send you the certificates. Okay, so please mark your attendance, all those who are already present here. Okay,
thank you.
You have already shared.
Yeah,
them.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. I hope so everybody have enjoyed this. This was a very marathon 1 hour session. I hope everybody have learned something. but I am giving you some techniques. I gave you some techniques already, so I expect you all will try and learn something. And if you have any comments, you can find us on these platforms. And I hope so. Everybody is doing their best. And I the last message: everybody should stay safe, and you have to take care of yourself and your family and friends, because we are going through a very difficult time. So I hope to see you everyone in next session. Have a nice day and goodbye.